हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर तुषार गुजराती फ्रॉम SNDT कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड रिसर्च सेंटर येवला। टुडे विल स्टडी द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक दैट इज रिडक्शन टेक्निक्स यूजफुल फॉर ब्लॉक डायग्राम रिडक्शंस। ओके, सो विल स्टडी नाउ द रिडक्शन टेक्निक्स। व्हाट आर द रूल्स फॉर रिडक्शन ऑफ ब्लॉक डायग्राम दैट विल स्टडी नाउ। सो व्हाट इज रिडक्शन टेक्निक्स? So it uses some formulas or some rules for combining different types of blocks. Okay, so first rule is combining blocks in cascade. Okay, so if you have notebook, you should write down these rules one by one, because we'll require these rules while solving the problems. In the next upcoming videos, I am going to show how to solve the problems, and that time you will require these rules in your notebook. Okay, so you just write down these rules one by one. So what is first rule? Combining blocks in cascade. So cascade meaning is series. So when two blocks in series, that is G1 and G2, both the blocks are in series, therefore their output is multiplication. G1 into G2, we get only one block having the value, that is G1 into G2. So you have to multiply that blocks when they are in series. Now second rule, you check when combining blocks in parallel. So there are two blocks are shown, G1 and G2, and both the blocks are in parallel and their signals are connected to a summing point. Okay, so depending upon sign of summing point, you have to add the signals or subtract the signals. Now in this case, both the signals are positive, that's why we have to add, that is plus G1 and plus G2. So our final block is G1 plus G2. So you write down these two rules, very important. So while parallel, we add the blocks. Okay, this you remember. Now third important rule is moving a summing point behind a block. Okay, so we have to move the summing point behind a block. So here in this case, now this is the summing point. Okay, so this summing point we have to move here behind the block. Okay, so what is required here? So you can shift the summing point like this, but you have to add one more box having the same value that you are crossing. Suppose you are crossing the summing point, you are crossing the summing point to this block, and the value of block is G. This block is value G. So you have to add same block in the parallel. Okay, in the parallel or in the line of summing point. Okay, so this block you have to add extra while shifting summing point behind a block. So this rule you remember. Now there is another rule is shown, that is moving a summing point ahead of a block. So now in this case, suppose you are moving this summing point ahead of a block, so you are crossing here block G. Okay, so when you are moving a summing point ahead of the block, then you can just shift it, but you have to add reciprocal of the block in the parallel. Suppose you are crossing the block G, then you have to add here reciprocal of the block, that is 1/G. You have to add this extra block. Okay, so this is the rule, summing point ahead of a block. Now next rule you check. What is next rule? Moving a pickup point behind the block. So this point is called as pickup point. Okay, now here this is called as pickup point. So this pickup point you have to move behind a block. Okay, so when you are moving the pickup point behind a block, at the time you have to add one more block of the reciprocal of the block which you are moving. Suppose you are crossing block G, at that time you have to add reciprocal of G, that is 1/G in the parallel. This is the rule. And similarly, suppose you are moving pickup point ahead of a block. Okay, ahead of a block. Suppose this pickup point you have to move here ahead of a block, then you have to add only G. There is no need to add reciprocal. So you only add G in the that particular signal. Okay, so like this you remember the rules or reduction techniques useful while solving the problems. Now another rule, that is eliminating feedback loop. Okay, So we know the formula, just we have seen in previous video. If we want to remove this feedback loop, at that time we have formula g upon 1 plus or minus gh. So in the numerator we have to write g, and in the denominator we have to multiply both the terms, g into h. So g upon 1 plus or minus gh. And in this formula, if it is negative feedback loop, then we have to take here in the formula plus, or if it is positive feedback loop, then we have to take in the formula negative sign. This you remember, okay? So if positive feedback loop is there, in the formula we take negative sign, and if negative feedback loop is present, then we take positive in the formula. Now the one more formula is there, if value of h is equal to 1, okay, at the time in this formula we have to put h equal to 1, and we will get this answer, g upon 1 plus or minus g. This is called as unity feedback loop, okay? Unity feedback loop, why? Because value of h is equal to 1. Now again, next rule, that is swap with two neighboring summing points. So here we have shown two neighboring summing points, okay, A and B. So these are same summing points but nearer to each other, then we can switch their positions, okay? We can write B first and A later, okay, and we can change their signals also. So we can shift the positions of neighboring summing points, means A can take position of B and B can take position of A. So this is possible, okay? So now here block diagram transformation theorems are shown here, okay? Just we'll see, actually the same way of studied, same thing is written here. So first block, combining blocks in cascade, we have seen. So what we do, we take the multiplication of two blocks, that is P1 into P2. If blocks are in parallel like this, okay, then what we do, we add the signals, okay? We add the signals. Third number, removing a block from a forward path. Suppose from forward path we want to remove the block, then what we do, we write here P1 upon P2 and multiply here by P2, okay? So like this we can remove a block from a forward path, okay? Now eliminating a feedback loop. Next is eliminating a feedback loop, fourth option. So we know the formula, that is P1 upon 1 plus or minus P2. This formula we have seen. Or removing a block from a feedback loop. So this can be done. We have to multiply P1 into P2 in the upper term, and here we have to write reciprocal. Okay. So here rule number 3 and rule number 5 are not usually required. We require only these rules, first, second and fourth. These rules are usually required. So you remember these three rules, important rules. Now again, some points are shown here, that is rearranging summing points. So you can rearrange summing points from one position to another. Suppose here x and here y, so you can shift the summing point like y and x, okay? Rearranging summing points here also shown, x, y is shown over here. You can write both the summing points up and down, one below another, okay? So moving a summing point ahead of a block, so if you move here, then you have to add here reciprocal 1 upon p, okay? If you move the summing point beyond a block, then you have to add the same block, okay, p as it is, you have to add. Now moving a take up point ahead of a block, so if you are moving this take up point ahead of a block, what we have to do, we have to keep same point, that we have to add p here as it is. If you are moving beyond a block, then you have to add reciprocal 1 upon p. So like this, there are important formulas are there that you have to remember. So next, formulas are usually not required as per our syllabus, so that's why we are not checking those rules. So thank you so much all of you for watching this reduction principles or reduction rules. So thank you so much for watching this video.